Hey friends, welcome back to my channel. Today I am very excited to kick off the first video in my Cosmic Footsteps book club series. Cosmic Footsteps is a book club where once a month for the entirety of 2024, I'm going to be reading a book by a classic science fiction fantasy female author, talking about it on my channel, and making a video like this where I review the book and talk a little bit about the author and some of their accomplishments. Now every month I give my patrons about 3 or 4 book options that we can read for the month, and they vote. And the first vote winner in January was Daughter of the Forest by Juliet Marillier. This is my first time reading anything by Juliet, and man, it was a great place to start. I will get into that. So the way that this video is going to work is I'm going to give you guys a little bit of an author bio, because one of the things that I think modern booktube sometimes misses out on is the stories of the authors who really paved a lot of the trails for those of us that are writing now. So I want to tell you guys a little bit about Juliet Marillier, and then at the end of the video I will give you my book review of Daughter of the Forest. Juliet Marillier was born in 1948 in New Zealand, and she grew up in a town that had strong Scottish heritage. She was raised by 2 musician parents, and her first career was actually in music. But later in life, she kind of hit a crossroads and finally decided to pursue her love of writing. Her first novel was Daughter of the Forest, and it was published in 1999, and it was the first of her well-known Seven Waters series. She is also the author of the award-winning Blackthorn and Grimm series, as well as the Brede Chronicles and many others. Since the debut of Daughter of the Forest, Juliet has published over 25 books that combine rich family sagas with historical eras and folklore magic. She has also written an impressive list of short stories. Her novels have won over 14 awards in a variety of categories. Juliet is a member of the Order of Bards, Ovates, and Druids, and her deep love and connection with nature plays a prominent role in all of her storytelling. One of the things I found in my research was an interview on YouTube that she did with Tony Lantis in 2022, and the link to that is down in the description box below if you want to watch it. But in it, Juliet opened up about the role of storytelling to explore and express trauma, and how her own life experiences played their part in creating the stories of her characters. Her deeply rooted philosophy on storytelling as a powerful agent for healing is an often explored theme in her work. Today, Juliet remains active on her website blog, shares updates about her writing and her daily life, and she's also a regular contributor on the blog Writer Unboxed, where I found a lot of really awesome down-to-earth advice and anecdotes of being a writer. She also teaches at writers' workshops in Western Australia, where she now lives. You can find links to all of those things down in the description box below, and I really encourage you guys to go out and watch the interview and read some of her blog posts, because she has a wealth of knowledge and such a humble, down-to-earth attitude about writing, and I really enjoyed reading through a lot of her blog entries. Now, moving on to my book review. The first book in Juliet's canon of work is Daughter of the Forest, which is book 1 of the Seven Waters series, and that was the one that I read here in January. I have to say I'm consistently surprised by some of the debut novels that I read, and this certainly is no different. You can tell that Juliet's love for not just writing and storytelling in the fantasy genre, but her very deep-seated love of folk tales really shines through. And I think one of the things that I want to say before I get into the world building and the characters and all of the detail type stuff of the review is that she combines kind of a historical fiction flavor with fantasy so seamlessly. It's the most seamless combination of those genres I think I've read ever, and it's a really beautiful thing to read, because at the fringes of the story there's always this kind of insinuated historical atmosphere and events, but it never crept in far enough to take away from the fantasy aspect or overpower the fantasy aspect. It was still very much a folktale, and it was very much a fantasy-led story. Now in Daughter of the Forest, we follow Sorsha, who is the youngest child of a very grumpy and depressed landowner noble father. She is the youngest of seven, and her six older siblings are all brothers. Now, this little family is incredibly tight-knit, and the sibling bonds in this book are so incredibly beautiful to read. It's a motley crew, all contained in a single family. I really loved getting to know the brothers through Sorsha's point of view, because as the youngest, there is definitely this kind of aspect of hero worship that goes on with a lot of them. And it makes sense, because with an emotionally absent father and a mother who passed away giving birth to Sorsha, her older brothers were left with the task essentially of raising their little sister. And I gotta say, I think they did a pretty good job. So in the very beginning of this story, we have these children growing up in a semi-idyllic life, despite the fact that their father is very emotionally closed off from them. But everything goes wrong when their father brings home a new woman to the castle who has very nefarious plans in place for this family and taking control of the lands that their father owns. This story definitely harkens back to a very, very ancient folktale about a group of brothers being cursed by an enchantress, and Juliet Marillier brings that story into this Irish mythology kind of setting in a really beautiful way. In the historical sense, we have the group of the Britons, who are the threat over the border, who there's kind of this constant fear in Sorsha's world of the Britons coming and invading, because they have tried to do it before, and there's this constant friction between these two nations. Sorsha, as she grows up and becomes a young woman, obviously her life becomes a lot more complicated than it was when she was a free-spirited child, kind of tagging along after her brothers. When the curse happens in this story, Sorsha's brothers, who have protected and loved her entire life, are now completely at her mercy, because she is the only person alive who can reverse what has been done. And the first part of this book really delves into Sorsha and her relationship with her brother and the conflict that is arising from this new person who's been added to their family, and the threat of control and, you know, nefariously used magic is very prevalent. In the rest of the story, we have this laser focus on Sorsha's journey to adulthood. In a lot of ways, it happens far too soon. Not only is she being asked to save the lives of her brothers at a very young age, but she's cast into the world alone far too early with no one to protect her. At the end of the day, this story is about resilience, it's about determination, it's about how far you will go for the people that you love the most. And I think Sorsha is a fantastic protagonist. She constantly embodies so many traits that we know and love from fantasy heroines, and the side cast of her brothers and the other characters she meets along the way just adds so much depth to the story. Not a single one of them felt unimportant or uninteresting, and I really appreciated the character work, especially, that Juliet Marillier was able to pull off in this story. Now, Sorsha's story takes a lot of surprising turns within the book, and it is just a beautiful, haunting tale, and I just really, really loved it. I binged this book. I read, I think, about 300 pages in one sitting at night. I could not put this book down. It is incredibly bingeable. The themes are really beautifully woven into the storyline. The world building is so atmospheric. There is a lot of mythology and folktale telling woven into the story, and it never once felt info dumpy or extraneous at all. I definitely want to mention here that there are a couple of content warnings for this book that you may want to look into before reading it, because it may be something that would be hard for some readers to read. It's a beautiful story, and I think that Juliet Marillier's way of handling trauma, especially to a young character, is incredibly well written and very respectful and very real. And that was something that I really appreciate, because I'm the type of person where I am not averse to reading traumatic experiences in the books that I'm reading. but I'm always on the lookout for them feeling gratuitous or out of place or just being there for kind of a shock value or being handled in a way that I think could be somewhat damaging. And this is so well done. It's so well done, but I definitely would encourage you to check the content warnings. I can definitely see this book being one that I will reread. I have already purchased the second and third books in the Seven Waters series because I do intend to continue it. This book definitely can stand on its own. It is a closed circuit story, and I felt incredibly satisfied at the end. And honestly, I just want to read more of Juliet's writing. And that's why I'm continuing on in the series, and I'm curious to see how she continues the generations of this family. But I would highly recommend this to anyone who's looking for a classic but very bingeable, readable, folktale vibes fantasy novel that is a standalone if you are looking for that type of a read. I could not be happier that this was our kickoff book for the Cosmic Footsteps book club. This just made me so excited to delve further into classic SFF because there are some obvious gems there that I think definitely deserve a lot more attention here on BookTube, and I am just super excited that this was the first pick. I had a blast reading this. I cannot wait to read more of Juliet's work. Definitely, again, check out the description box below for those links and that information about her. She's an incredibly interesting woman, and I loved reading about her on her blog and watching the interviews, so definitely check out those links down in the description box below. I would love to know if you participated in this read-along this month. Let me know down in the comments what you thought, if you've read it before. I would love to hear more about your experience reading this book. I had an awesome experience. I will definitely be recommending this book to people because I think it is incredibly well written and beautiful, and it's character driven, which you guys know I love. So that is my overall book review for Daughter of the Forest by Juliet Marillier. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this content, please leave a like and a subscribe. I hope you are having an awesome week. I hope you are reading five-star reads, and I will see you in the next video.